a 27-year-old woman presents to the emergency department with a sudden onset of swelling of the hands and face. She describes multiple similar episodes over the past few years, but this episode is the most severe. She cannot recall any obvious precipitant. On previous occasions, the symptoms have subsided within 30 minutes, but on these occasions, they have worsened over the course of an hour. On examination, there is a significant swelling of lips, which are dry and shiny, tongue not enlarged. There is no stridor, chest clear, respiration okay, 22, and oxygen saturation 96. Hands are swollen, slightly erythematous, but there is no pain, no itching, no lymphadenopathy. Heart rate 106, blood pressure normal. Tympanic temperature, that is, she's afebrile. Diagnosis is hereditary angioedema. Which one of the following is not implicated in the pathogenicity of hereditary angioedema? So basically, here a few things we need to understand. It's not, first of all, their target is it's hereditary angioedema is different from anaphylaxis. That we need to understand. Anaphylaxis is much rapid in onset, much deleterious on the system, but it is more continuous, more prolonged kind of onset. And mostly, unless the upper respiratory tract area is not involved, this is mostly confined to a particular limb or local region. There are a number of recurrences which are found in this. Previously, it was just okay, just she recovered within 30 minutes without any intervention. Now, coming to anaphylaxis and this one, hereditary angioedema, it is an autosomal dominant disease. So, what we find, we found episodic swelling of extremities along with mucosal edema. Precipitating factors are not very well traced. However, ACE inhibitors and estrogen, these two are connected to hereditary angioedema precipitation. Normally, what we can see that in hereditary angioedema, C1 esterase deficiency or C4 esterase deficiency or dysfunction is present. However, in type 3 variety of hereditary angioedema, there is no deficiency or no dysfunction of this esterase variety is seen. Hereditary angioedema, the issue is, you see, C1 esterase inhibitor that is a part in the pathogenesis of it. Bradykinin is a part in pathogenesis of it. Kallikrein is a part, and high molecular weight kininogen all are the part. Whereas anaphylaxis, that is basically an IgE-mediated immune phenomena, which basically causes degradation and degranulation of mast cell, which leads to histamine release. So that's the only part, only thing which mismatches over here. So histamine is the answer for the question. However, a few new things that I would like to inform over here. What is the treatment option for hereditary angioedema? So one is we can go for a recombinant human C1 esterase inhibitor. Two varieties, two brands are present in available in the UK. One is Cinryze, the other is Berinet. There is another option is using a specific bradykinin antagonist, B2 bradykinin receptor antagonist that we can use over here, and it is called icatibant. So again, icatibant, cinnarized bradykinin. Another option is inhibiting the kallikreins. So kallikrein inhibitor we can use, and the name is ecallantide. Always remember, hereditary angioedema does not respond to adrenaline or antihistamine or steroids. Prophylaxis for HAE treatment or HAE attack, prophylaxis for HAE, there is some role of danazol, which is an anabolic steroid.